And I'm thrilled to be back in this incredible place with thousands of proud, hardworking American patriots. That's what you are. You are hardworking. You're great. We know how good you are. And we're bringing this country back fast. We're going to bring it back fast. I'd like to begin by asking you a very simple question. Are you better off now than you were 4 years ago? With your vote on Tuesday, I will end inflation. I will stop the invasion of criminals coming into our country. And I will bring back the American dream. We're going to bring back the American dream. We're just 2 days away from what will be the most important political event in the history of our country. I believe that. But you have to do one little thing. I don't want your money. I don't want anything. The only thing I want is get out and vote. Just get out. Finish it. You know, we're on the five-yard line, maybe even the one-yard line. We're right there. We had a tremendous number of early votes, a record-setting number, records like nobody can believe. Thank you. But all I can say is, on Tuesday, just go out and vote, and we're going to close this thing out, and it's going to be party time. It's going to be party time. And this is really all you need to know. Kamala broke it, and I'll fix it, and we'll do it very quickly. America will be bigger, better, bolder, richer, safer, and stronger than ever before. We start from a very bad place. We're a nation in decline. We're a nation in decline like we've never seen a decline. What they've done to our beautiful country is just so horrible. And we have so many senators, so many congressmen and women, and just we have so many great people in the audience, and they're working with me. We're going to bring this back like never before. Nobody's going to believe it. We're going to drill, baby, drill. We're going to bring it back so fast. This election is a choice between whether we will have 4 more years of gross incompetence and failure, or whether we will begin the 4 greatest years in the history of our country. This will be the golden age of America. What a beautiful, isn't that a beautiful term? Think of that, the golden age. This will be the golden age of America. Think of that, how beautiful that sounds, and it's true. Remember, we have more liquid gold under our feet than Saudi Arabia, than Russia, than anybody. And I told a great guy, RFK Jr., Bobby, I said, Bobby, you work on women's health, you work on health, you work on what we eat, you work on pesticides, you work on everything. The one thing you have to let me do, Bobby, I got to work the liquid gold. You're not going to touch that. We don't want too much advice. We don't want too much advice, Marco, on the liquid gold. We're going to pay off our debt. We're going to do things that you wouldn't believe, and we're going to give you — I gave you the biggest tax cut in the history of our country. You'll get still more. We're going to make our country so competitive. On Tuesday, you have to stand up and tell Kamala or Kamala or Harris. You know, when I say Harris, nobody knows who the hell I'm talking about. I said, Harris was out tonight. Who's Harris, sir? Nobody knows who she is. But on Tuesday, you have to stand up and tell Harris that you've had enough. You can't take it anymore. You're the worst vice president in the history of our country. It's the worst administration in the history of our country. Kamala, you're fired. Get out. Get out. You're fired.
USA! 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 USA!
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. This is a big place. This place is packed, and you have more people outside. I always ask this. Would anybody like to give up their ticket to somebody outside? No? Would anybody like to hand over their gun to Kamala? Is there anybody, one person in this giant tens of thousands of people, one person would like to hand out their gun? You'd be famous for the rest of your life? That's what she wants. She wants to confiscate your guns. You know that. With your vote, we are going to win Georgia. We are going to defeat Kamala. And we are going to make America great again. Over the past 4 years, Kamala has orchestrated the most egregious betrayal that any leader in American history has ever inflicted upon its people. What she has done is not acceptable. It's so bad. She has violated her oath, eradicated our sovereign border, and unleashed an army of gangs and criminal migrants. I mean, we have migrants pouring in here by the tens of thousands that are criminals from jails, from mental institutions, terrorists. They come from mental institutions, and they come from insane asylums, and they come from all around the world, from Venezuela to the Congo. Lots of people coming from the jails of the Congo, stealing countless American lives, and they do nothing about it. These are open borders. They come in totally unchecked and unvetted. Just days ago, right here in your state, an incredible 25-year-old mom, beautiful mom, named Mimi Rodriguez Ramirez, was kidnapped from a Walmart parking lot that was safe. She was horribly abused and murdered, violently murdered. A week later, her body was dumped on a road, was found by the police in condition that they said they've never seen anything like that before. The animal who murdered Mimi was an illegal alien who came to Georgia to maim and kill people. It made no difference who they were. Mimi leaves behind a 9-year-old daughter and her absolutely wonderful mother, Carmen. Yesterday, my friend, a very wonderful man and a very patriotic and philanthropic man, had the fortune to make a lot of money, and he gives a lot of his money away. He's just very amazing. In fact, he made contributions to Georgia with your hurricane problems, and he made tremendous contributions to North Carolina, Alabama, think of all these states, Tennessee, South Carolina, Florida, what a horrible thing that was. But my friend's name is Steve Witkoff, and he reached out to Carmen when he heard about it. And I'd like to ask Steve, he doesn't know I'm going to do this, and he may not want to speak in front of 40,000 people because I don't know if he's ever done it before. But Steve is just this incredible guy, and if it's okay with you, Steve, I'd love to have you come up and say some wonderful things about Mimi and Carmen and that incredible family that's been decimated. Steve Witkoff.